Good morning, students. Now today we will see organizing data. Okay, so what is meant by organizing data? Yesterday we have learned about bar graph, double bar graph, then pictograph. Okay, today we will see organizing data. So organizing data means what? Usually the data available to us is in unorganized form, is called raw data. Unorganized form means if any particular information about, suppose to be the students, if you want to take the information about the favorite subject of the students, favorite colors of the students, then means any different another things, if you ask, then we can collect the information only, right? So anyhow we will collect the information, that is the unorganized data. It is called unorganized form means what? Raw data. Okay, so to draw the meaningful inferences we need to organize the data is systematically, so that we will get the proper information. So for example, suppose we asked to the students from the class 8, right? Many students are there, supposed to be 40 students are there or 25, so on. Okay, so if we ask to the students which subject do you like most, or what is your favorite subject, if you will ask one by one to the student, so some students will say for one of the students say arts, science, math, English, and so on. Okay, so up to the last students, if you will ask, the last students will say the English, right? So most of the students like which subject? English subject. Then some of the students like the math, some of the students like the arts, right? But this is the unorganized data, right? Why this unorganized data? Because from this information we cannot tell directly how many students like maths, how many students like English, how many students like arts, and how many students like science. Okay, and we cannot say properly the which subject is the most favorite subject of the students. Okay, so this is the unorganized data, this is the raw data for us. Okay, so to get the meaningful inferences we need to organize this systematically. Now we will draw this information, we will set the information in one of the table, and see here I will draw now the table. Here I will write subject. Okay, and here see why we can see and what will be here in these two columns. Okay, first I will take art subject, then maths, science, and which one? English. Mostly four subjects are there. Okay, see now first subject, first students like mostly subject art subject, so art, so I will take here art, first students got art, then second science, this science I will do the marking for the science, then maths, third one students like most maths, fourth one English, again I will draw here for the English one line, then maths, here again I will do this maths, art, English, okay, maths again, then English again, then arts, science, where is the science? Yes, science, then this art, okay, science, this science, again maths, okay, English, then art. Now we are here, art. Now here how many completed students? 1, 2, 3, 4, up till whatever we have read the sequence, in that 4 students like art, right? Now this one, fifth one, so when we will count the fifth one students, we have to make this cross mark. Okay, so cross mark means that this is the group of the 5 students, or 5 is completed here. This is the bunch of 5 object. Okay, now here afterward maths, so now maths 1, 2, 3, 4 are there, we will do this, right? then science, science already completed 1, 2, 3, 4, this science. Okay, then English, English also will come now, complete 5. Then again maths, here, science, okay, English, and finished. Okay, now see here, arts, maths, science, English. So this marking of the lines is called tally marks. Okay, tally marks. From this we can tell how many students like each and every subject. Okay, arts, how many students are there? 5. Maths, how many students like most? 6. Science, 6. And English also 6. Okay, so this is called frequency. This is called frequency. Okay, so frequency means here what? Here the number of students, how many number of students that like the particular subject, like the particular color, like the particular food material, right? So number of, how many number that shown by this number, that is the frequency. Okay, or this arts comes how many times in this table or in this data, that is how many times? 5 times, and this is the frequency of the art. This art is occurred how many times? 5 times. English occurred how many times in the given data? 6 times. So 6 is the frequency of English subject. Understood what is the frequency? And this is called tally marks. Now from this table only, if table is given, this is the organized data, right? This is organized data, and if we organize the data properly, we can get the proper information about each and every subject. Okay, and also we can tally the how many total students are there. See this, 6 plus 6, 12 plus 6, 18, 18 plus 5, 23, right? If you count this, all this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, all are there. Okay, so this is, observations or data in the form of the frequency table, and this is called the ungrouped frequency distribution of raw data, right? Now again, when the number of observations or when the number of recorded observations is large, or and the data is usually organized into the group, and then we obtain the frequency distribution, is called group frequency distribution. Okay, means what if the, in a class or in the 8 class, in 3 divisions, supposed to be division A, B, C, there are supposed to be the 150 students are there. Okay, so if we think about the marks scored by the students in the mathematics or any other subject, supposed to be science, the marks scored by the students in the science subject in the class test are, we will record, make the record of the students. Suppose we will generally write down that 1 mark, 2 mark, 3 mark, 5 mark, 7 mark, 9 mark, some students got the 0 mark, like this. So there are how many students are there? If in the 3 divisions 150 students are there, then there are how many numbers will come? Exactly 150 numbers will come. Means 150 numbers will becomes, mean what? Data will becomes, data will large. Means how many students, that much marks are there, right? Types of marks are there. Means some students got 10 marks, some students will got, some students having 9 marks, 19 marks, 20 marks, correct? So there are the types of marks are there. Types of marks means in the sense, some students 1 mark, some students 0 mark, right? Then 2 marks also students are there, 3 marks also will be there, up to 50. So is it possible to arrange the 50 marks? And in front of that, how many students got 0 marks, in the how many students got 1 marks? Not possible. So for that purpose, we have to arrange this data or arrange this marks into the particular manner to make the group of the marks like this, 0 to 10 marks, right? So how many students got 0 to 10 marks? It means that marks 0, more than 0, but less than 10. So next group in that 10 to 20. So of course 10 mark students will come into the second group. Okay, so that we will see with the help of example what is the group frequency distribution, and the table is called frequency distribution table. Okay. Okay, now we will see grouping data in that this how to make the group frequency distribution table and why we can say that group frequency distribution. Okay, so here marks obtained by the students in the math test. So many students are there, right? Here in this class, this much students are there and they got the different marks out of 50 marks. Okay, in the math test, out of 50 marks, they got 30, 22, 17, 47, 30, 45, 36, 20, that is up to 24, and last one students also got the 24, right? So there are different marks. Different marks means some students who got the 1 mark, some students who got the supposed to be 10 marks, 20 marks, 21 marks. So different types of different numbers are there. So that much marks are there, right? So is it possible to arrange the data in that supposed to be student got 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like this? Is it possible to arrange? Or if you take the robust number supposed to be here 10, so 10, then 11, 12, up till 50, is it possible? Not possible. So there is a need to make the group of the particular marks. Okay, now we are going to make here the group of the marks, and afterwards we will do the frequency distribution table. So total marks are 50, so we will make the group of the marks 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, and 40 to 50. Okay, so here this marks. Okay, and when we will arrange these marks into the group, so that is called class. Okay, if we are arranging the marks into the group method, means that 0 to 10. So 0 to 10 is the class. Okay. Then here 10 to 20. Okay. 20 to 30 marks. 30 to 40 marks. 40 to 50 marks. Okay, this is your last group. Now here we will make the tally marks. Means we have to make the marking to count the students. Okay, and last column will be what? Yes, of course. What is frequency? Means how many students got the marks 0 to 10 marks. How many students got the marks 10 to 20. Then 20 to 30, 30 to 40, like this. Okay, so this frequency. Okay, now here the students got the 0 to 10 means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. So this see the second class is there 10 to 20. So here when we will arrange the marks and or when we do the tally marks of the marks, then we have to count here the mark, the students got the marks 0, more than 0 but less than 10, and 10 marks students, the students got exactly 10 marks, that students will come in this class. Okay, so in this class the students marks are 10, more than 10 but less than 20. Understood? Here 20 to 30 in that which students will come? Yes, 20 marks, more than 20 marks but less than 30 marks. Okay, so here I will write 0, more than 0, right? But less than 10. Okay, here 10, more than 10 but less than 20. Here 20, more than 20 and less than 30. Here students having the marks 30, more than 30 and less than 40. Similarly for this. Okay. Now we will make the tally marks. 30. Now 30 number students, the students got the 30 marks. In which table will come 20 to 30 or 30 to 40? Here 30. In this class it will not come because their marks are 20, more than 20 and less than 30. Right, and say next group there is the marks are 30. So 30 marks students will come in this group. Okay, once our completed, make the right mark or you make the cross mark. Okay, then 22. In which group 22 will come? 22, 30. Then 70. 70 will come in this second. Correct? 47. In which 47 will come? 42, 50. Right? Then 45. 45 will also come in this class. 36. 36 where will come? 32, 40. 20. 20 will come in which class? This first class. Second class or third class? In this class, third one class. Okay, 22, 30. So here will come. Okay. Then 7. 7 will come 0 to 10. 16. 16 will come 10 to 20. 48 will come 40 to 50 class. Correct? Then 15. 15 in which class? In which class? There, so here 50 means completely 50. So there is one more extra class for this distribution. So it is 50 to 60. Okay, because 50 marks will come in this class, right? So 50 completed, then 39. 39 in which class will come? 30 to 40. Correct? 36. 36 again in this class will come 30 to 40. 33. 33 in which class? The same class. So here 1, 2, 3. Here in this class only will come, right? So there are 4 completed, so we will give it one line, right? 33. Then 36. Okay. Next, 36. 36 in which class will come? 30 to 40. Okay, then 21 and 18. 21, 18. 21 will come in this class and 18 will come 10 to 20, right? Then 10, 20. 10 will come in this class 10 to 20 and 20 will come in this class 20 to 30. Okay, this completed. Then 26, we will take like this, 30, 26, 30 will come in this class, 30 to 40, 26 will come in this class, so here 4 completed, this one 5, okay, then 38, 29, here 38 will come in this class, 30 to 40, and here 29 will come in this class, okay, 20 to 32, where 22 will come, 20 to 30 class, and 32 will come, 32, 40 class, okay, 22 and 18, now 22 will come in which class, this class, and 18 will come in this class, so here 4 completed, this 5, okay, then 33, 32, where 33, in this class, 32, 40, so here 5 completed, and 32, in which group 32 is there, here, okay, then 44, 23, 44 where, here in this class, 44, and 23 in this class, getting, then 5, 27, here 5 will come 0 to 10, and 27 will come 10 to 20 to 30, so here again 5 completed, okay, 16 and 31, here 16 will come this class, and 31 will come 30 to 40 class, okay, 37, 28, here 37 in this class, 37 and 21, 28 in this class, okay. Then afterwards, 24, 21. 24 is here and 21 is also
here. Okay, 12, 29. Here 12, 10 to 20, and 29 here 20 to 30. Then 10, 34. 10 in which class? This class. 10 and 34 in this class. Okay. Then 25, 19. Where 25 will come in this class? So again 5 will come. 25, 19 will come here. Okay. Then 27, 22. Where is the 27? In this class, and 22 also in this class. Okay. 42, 35. Where 42? 42 here. And 35 also in this class. Okay. Completed. Then 39, 33. Where is the 39? In this class, and 33 also in this class. Then 15, 31. Where is the 15? 15 and 31 is here. Okay. Then 28, 36. Where is the 28? In this class 28 and 36 in this class. Okay. Next 39, 49. 39 in this class and 49 in this class. 40 to 50. Okay. Remaining one 24 and 24. Okay. So this 24 and 24 will come this class only. This 24 and again this 24. Understood? So the data is given in a such a manner, it is not possible to write them individually. So we have to make the groups like this, and we have to arrange the marks in this manner. So this is called group frequency distribution table. Okay, in this group frequency distribution table, these groups are is called the class. Okay, so now frequency we will count. How many students got the marks? Between the 0 to 10 means 0, more than 0 but less than 10. There are total how many students? 2. Here 5 and 5 is 10. Here 5, 10, 15 and 20. Here 5, 10, 15, 20. Here 6 and here 1. So how many total students are there? 20, 20, 40, 50, 56, 57, 58. And 59. So total students are how many are there? 59. Okay. So 59 students are there, and they score the marks in such that we have arranged these marks into the group frequency distribution. Okay. So this is called class. Then this is called class or class interval. Okay, this is class interval in that this class interval 0 to 10. So 0 to 10 is the class interval, 10 to 20 is the class interval, 20 to 30 is the class interval, and so on. So this class interval in that 0 to 10, suppose. So 0 to 10 and next 10 to 20. So this side are called the upper limit, and these are called lower limits. Okay, so what is the class size? Class size means the difference between the upper limit and lower limit of the class interval is called class size. So what is 20 minus 10, difference is subtraction. 20 minus 10, it is 10. So 10 is the class size or class width of the class interval. Okay, we can see. Understood? Now, and what is the next? Class mark. So what is mean by class marks? The class marks is the midpoint of upper limit and lower limit, right? So upper limit and lower limit. So how to find the midpoint of this class? 10 plus 20 by adding the upper limit and lower limit, dividing by then by 2. Okay, so what is here the class mark? If you have to find for the class mark of this, so 10 plus 20 by 2 equals to 30 by 2. So it means that 15 is the class mark. Okay, 15 is the
class map. What is the class size? Class size is the difference between the upper limit and lower limit, that is the tail. Okay, and what are the upper limit, lower limit? That you know that this left hand side marking is lower limit, right hand side marking is upper limit. Understood? Thank you.